So the Sabres finally show some life late after the Gudas penalty. The aggressive play by the coach, Don Granato, with the power play as Krebs bumps into Gibson. Hit him up near the head area. The Ducks don't like it. We got a scrum with 39.5 to go. Going to take some penalties here. Probably some coincidentals. Wrestling matches continue. Watch out, here's Krebs. Remember, Krebs looks like he might go with Henrique. He wants him. Here we go. Henrique and Krebs. Big left from Henrique. Henrique still wants a piece of Krebs. Tavish is in there.
Well, you were talking before about the Sabres, you know, what are they, where's their emotion?
Yeah, they needed this in the first period.
Yeah, they did. And this is what I was looking for at the beginning of the third period from them, too. They were down 3-0 at that point, and either a big hit or a fight or something to show that they're in this, that they're in it to win it. And when things aren't going your way, that's what you need. I mean, 39.5 seconds left. Not much for them, but maybe that sets them up for tomorrow night. We talked about it's a very quick trip. Freeway up to L.A. or down to L.A., out to L.A.
Carrick is done. 39.5. Henrique will go to the box. Got a feeling the Ducks might get the extra penalty. Not that it matters too much, but there is close to 40 seconds left. Tavish will head to the room. Could be some 10-minute misconducts here as well.
Henrique's going to the room.
Yeah, he wanted Krebs. Carrick and Apostol were having words, but Tavish, who's a big, strong, young player, put his face right in the middle of that.
Usually they're also dropping their sticks, and we can see, they're playing on the Jumbotron. We showed before, they've got their sticks in there. There's a big mush, and the linesmen are earning their keep late in the game.
Here we go. Lots of bookkeeping. Like I said, I think we're going to see some 10-minute misconducts. Get the twigs all sorted out.
Make sure you get the one that belongs to you.
Yep. And there's not a Sabre stick in there. So Gibson took the initial shot up in the head area. He didn't like it. His teammates didn't like it. I think it was Krebs who supplied that little bit of contact. He's kind of embracing that fourth line grindy pest role. Still trying to sort this thing out. Chris Lee's number 28. Trevor Hansen, number 14. It's Jordan Greenway, who was really impressive down the stretch. Here it is, that initial hit. I believe it was Krebs, who just kind of brushed near the dome of Gibson.
Position. Their heads are down, they're looking at the puck, so there's always going to be a sense of protecting your goalies. That didn't look egregious to me from where we're looking after the fact.
Defenseman
out there, maybe some embellishment, but this point in the game too, he's a little, Krebs a little off balance, his shoulders down, and he's sort of coming in anyway. But you know what, I do appreciate that Ducks coming to his defense. I think that you got to send a message, don't go anywhere near my goalie.
Right, and if you can avoid it, you should avoid it.
I don't know that Krebs could have.
Yeah,
look,
right, it's close.
In there too.
Hard to figure it out. I think looks like now Buffalo might have the extra two. Benson goes to the box. He wasn't involved. So I think it's a 2-minute power play for the Ducks to end this game.
And we were just talking, if you can avoid it, you should at all costs. Krebs is a little off balance. He's just on one skate coming in, knocked around a little bit. So again, easy to make judgment when we're looking at it after the fact in slow motion with all the different angles, but it did not look egregious to me in that moment. But it is good to see both teams bubble over with some emotion. The first half of this game was a little sleepy, so they come alive here and give the crowd something to cheer for.